first time I've ever seen this section over here was in the 50s, early 50s. And I come over through the field here, parked over there, come over through the field, and I found this, like a little bench here at the base of this hickory tree. Look at this. Like a little bench I've got here. And I would spend anywhere from, 15 minutes to an hour just sitting right here. I taper my leader, and watch the surface while I'm doing two things at once. Observing, checking things out, and if I seen a trout work, what I would do is I would mark it with my eye. And I've followed that practice all my life. I don't rush into it. What I do is just, like I said, I sit here, observe, and mark. I spend anywhere from 15 minutes to an hour doing this, taping my own leaders, sitting at the base of this tree, in a solitude. It just overwhelms you. There's nobody but me. Jack is by himself here. And I've closed to civilization, but yet I'm a million miles away. And I can relax, really enjoy myself and relax, and really get into this thing, this fly fishing. Look at the water, just look at it. Just, oh my, the setting. And like I said, this is just a little piece of heaven. I've had it all, and I've seen it all on this little stretch of water. God, I love it so much, And you get a little jealous of it too. You don't like other people to know about it, but the only people you do like to know about is these people that you just hope to God, if they do fish it, they appreciate it for what it is. They're careful of it, and hopefully that the trout are too beautiful to kill, to be only caught once. And I know most of the fellows that I fish with taught how to fly fish that. They think like I do. That picture to catch that trout, the hooking, that fight, the landing of that trout, and putting that fish back. That's the ultimate right there. Just to enjoy it for those couple moments in your hand and to release it again to fight another day. But that's it. Like I said, this has been so special to me all my life, right here, this one particular spot. I think everybody has that one place that they go to, that they look for, that they want, that they need. This is something I need. I can come in here and I can sit and everything is gone. Everything is gone. The problems of the day, no matter what it is, they're gone. They're gone. At least momentarily, they're gone.
I think that every sport has its paradigm. Golf, for example, has Augusta. The football players have the Super Bowl. Baseball has Yankee Stadium. These things represent the essence of the sport. And I think that what really represents the essence of fly fishing is a stream like this, these limestone spring-fed trout streams. They are absolutely, I think, the granddaddy of the fly fishing experience. And the thing about it is that there's only one stream like this that was created, and never in the history of the earth or the universe will there ever be another creation like this. And that is probably the most significant aspect of it, is protecting a resource like this for forever and for the generations to come, so they can experience the same thing that we have experienced on these types of streams. Now that was a downstream or upstream. That's a pretty nice fish. Just perceptively, just sucked it right in. Very nice fish here. Come on, baby. I'm gonna let you go. I'm gonna let you go. That's the way to do it.